you did this analysis back in 2018 with your lead manager. Like, what happened after that? You guys started getting more listings. Maybe what percentage of them turned into listings versus actual cash deals?
Yeah, we changed our game plan too, is we were buying more rentals too. So around that time. So I don't have from scaling a flipping. I really wish I could, because I've gone back and did the numbers. Well, this will be helpful. Based on the 130, what I did is I went back and said, hey, if we can close 30, because I had no idea at the time what a real estate agent, what the closing ratio for a realtor is. I said, hey, if I'm a horrible realtor and I close 30% of them as listings based on my average price point of the market homes I'm targeting, that was $200,000 in gross commission. So I was just like, okay, that's why I realized, okay, well, I need to pay attention to this, because that's a decent amount of money.
A lot of money. Yeah. There's no way that's a lot of money.
Correct. Good listing agents close around 70 to 80, even some 90% of appointments.
Wow. Okay.
So at scale, I can go back and track that of how it would have worked. Now we changed our position, because, you know, me and you've had a conversation about this. Is like, well, do we really want to do this at scale anymore? Or do we actually just want to hold on to more rentals? So that's end up what we've done. So we've actually done more listings, less flips. So basically we've done rentals or listings, and we did a couple flips during that time period. But if you go look at what realtors are doing, they're closing 70, 80% or so of all their appointments. So you got to figure out how many appointments are you closing from a motivated seller? At the time, it was about 1 in 7 for me. So 1 in 7 mm-hmm. actual appointments I went on and closed as an acquisition, which meant 6 out of 7 I didn't close. Now, probably 1 or 2 of those were, they're just completely tire kickers. So maybe you just add 5. I mean, so 70% of those 5, I should have been able to close as a listing.
It's still crazy numbers. I mean, that's an additional multiple 6 figures just from adding this like other component. And like,
It gets better than that. You know, so this is the realtor game. You get a listing. Every listing should generate like 3 to 5 buyers. So this is what realtors do. The listing is like a sign. It's like a billboard. It's hey buyers, come look here. A lot of those buyers will be represented, but not all of them. And those that aren't, you can help them go out and find a house. If you have a team, you let your team members work on them. Or if you're a solo agent, you work with them too. Mm-hmm. Now, 50 to 60% of those buyers also have a home to sell. See what we're doing here?
And so it just grows.
Correct. And the lifetime value of a, I should look this up before we get on, because I was doing the math. It's like the lifetime value, the average wholesale fee when I was looking that up, and it's probably a little higher now with the market, but it was around 6 to 7 grand, which really is pretty close to what it costs to even get a deal. So most wholesalers aren't really making money. There are a lot of them that are, and I know some really good ones, but I mean, if you're wholesaling on average 6 to 7 grand, you're just not making money. But the ones that are doing 15, 20, 30, that's fine. But the lifetime value of a client for a realtor in the business over the long term is around 20 grand, 20 to 25 grand, because you take them, which you'll get a couple transactions out of them throughout their lifetime, but every client's going to refer a couple folks over to you. And then of course they have a value. So it's that multiplier effect. So what I teach flippers, because mainly flippers, the wholesalers too, but mainly flipper, because you have an extra vested interest, the fact that you're actually putting properties on the market all the time. If you can integrate this in your business, now you don't necessarily probably don't want, and maybe you do, but a lot of flippers probably don't want to be involved in the active traditional realtor game. So you can get agents on your team to work the buyer leads, and you could just work the listing leads and even get a listing assistant to do much of the work there. But you can totally vertically integrate that where you have a full service solution to all the prospects that come through your door. And this is going to be required to stay competitive. Like, you don't think like Zillow, they know this. Open Door does this. They do it on the back end. Because if you've ever tried to put one of your deals through Open Door, through their platform and you didn't take an offer, you might have, depending on your market, you might've gotten a call from a realtor a couple of weeks later. They're very slow at it, but they'll catch up. It's all affiliate services. That's why Zillow has mortgage. That's why they have insurance. That's why they have closing and title. It's affiliate services. And they do that because as competition rises, margins shrink. It requires a vertical integration to be able to keep your margins at scale. And I think that's the best way you can grow your business in a healthy way without just trying to scale only using the marketing arm, meaning pour money on marketing.